60,000 participants and 900 exhibitors from about 130 countries, the Singapore FinTech Festival is certainly the largest of its kind in the world. It is an extensive gathering of financial institutions, fintech startups, policymakers, and investors to discuss the latest trends in the digital finance world.
For green finance in Asia.
One area that featured prominently in discussion is financial inclusion, or addressing the needs of those people who have not used a financial service before. According to the World Bank's Global Findex report for 2017, 69% of people now have a bank account or a mobile money provider, up from just 51% in 2011. However, around 1.7 billion adults still remain unbanked. Among these, 225 million are in China. WeBank, China's first digital-only bank, is catered to this underserved population. Using technology, the company has managed to serve a large number of people using minimal resources.
We run AI chatbot to serve our customer base. We leverage blockchain to facilitate collaboration with our partners. We build our own private cloud to house our whole banking infrastructure. And we leverage data to build a very data-driven business to do risk management and precision marketing. All that helps us to increase our operational efficiency and at the same time be able to cut down costs and also mitigate risk.
WeBank leveraged its largest shareholder Tencent's existing ecosystem and technology to create a product that can be scaled up without breaking the bank. It offers easy access to microloans through WeiLiDai and allows users to apply for those loans directly from the WeChat Pay app. Today, it has 170 million small and medium-sized customers and processes 400 million transactions on a daily basis.
WeBank is a really great, again, really great case study of where digital banking goes right. And so by focusing on SMEs specifically with their services, they're really tapping into a largely underserved segment. You create a really, really low-cost way of providing those services. And that has huge impacts not only on city dwellers, where the majority of GDP is generated, but also rural areas which really don't have access to branches. And so that digitization is really key, both in China and then the region as a whole.
Thanks to technology, the way we bank is evolving. Most customers are no longer satisfied with what the traditional banks are offering. They're looking for convenience that's literally on their fingertips. Analysts predict that it is these user expectations that will drive innovation and digital transformation in the coming years.